Hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to be sharing with you a Dollar Tree haul. They've already started stocking their Halloween stuff, so I wanted to get in there early and get first picks of all of the fun stuff. So I bought quite a few things. Let's just dig right in. The first thing that I got was these Trick or Treat jack-o'-lantern cups. They are, I don't know, they're standard size cups, and you can use cups all year long. So I love stuff like that. The next thing I got was this basket. Obviously, you could use this for candy, but what I think I'm gonna do for it is maybe line it with some Halloween fabric and use it as a little pumpkin cornucopia type display. That's what I'm thinking about doing with it. I really like that it's obviously a spider web and it has little spiders. I think this is adorable. I got some other stuff here too. All the stuff is down below me in the bags. So the next couple things that I got are just little hanging things. I got this little sparkly black spider on a web, and I got this handsome little skull here. He was also sparkly. And this one is kind of hard to read. It says Happy Halloween, and it's got the purple spider on it. If you guys have not noticed, I do have a spider tattoo on my arm. I love spiders. Well, I hate spiders. Like, someone, if a spider came creeping along, But I love the creepiness of Halloween and spiders. So there's that, right? Let's grab the next bag here. All right, so some of the stuff that I got today is not Halloween themed, because I am shopping for my friend's daughter. Her fourth birthday is this month, and so when I went into the Dollar Tree today, they had My Little Pony. They had this ball, and I was like, that is perfect for this little girl. She's gonna love it. So my haul is a ton of Halloween stuff and then a couple My Little Pony items, which I was happy to find. Anyways, so the next thing that I got, look how cute this is. He is so cute. And then when you open him up, I love that there's another print inside. I think that is so cute. So you could present him like this. And you could put little candy inside of him. You could put whatever you wanted. Put him on a coffee table. I think that that is a great, super cute little dish. Or, you know, you can maybe attach some hinges to him and display him on a bookcase. There are plenty of different uses for him. So also at my local Dollar General, now I did go to two different Dollar Generals. I went to a Dollar General that is by my job, and then one that's by my house. Now, my home is on the opposite side of town as my job. They're about half an hour apart. So they had some of the same things, but the Dollar Tree by my house had like a whole lot more than the Dollar Tree by my job. So they had these little glass or ceramic figures, and they had this little guy. It's the Grim Reaper, and he's got his scythe, and he's by a tree, and all around he's standing here by a tombstone, and I think that that was super cute. And then they had some other little glass figures. So then they have this witch here who has her broomstick and her little hat, and then she's got little potion bottles over here. And I was like, this is adorable. Move those little guys to the side there. I plan on like setting her outside, her little house there, and setting him up. Move this over here. Setting him up it maybe, maybe over this way, maybe back like this. Something type of dealio. You know, just something that they kind of go together. This one, it's got a little gate there, and it's got the little jack-o'-lantern. So you could also put her, the witch, with him too, kind of position it like this. You know what I mean? They have a lot of different options for stuff like that. But I do love this witch's house here. So it even has like the little hat on the top for the witch, and it's decorated all around. It's got a little door there on the side and a door there on the front. And I think like for the dollar store, this stuff is so awesome. Now I have some Halloween knickknacks that I am super, super excited to have. So the next thing I got are some window clings. And there's like a little spider and some little poison bottles and different little skulls and skeletons. And he has a little top hat. And I thought this was adorable. They had other window decorations, like other little window decals and stuff like that. But they were like witches or pumpkins, and I love witches and pumpkins, but I thought these were the absolute cutest. And I plan on not just decorating my front window and door. I want to do my back door, my kitchen window, maybe my kids' window. I don't know. They tend to get into anything I put in their room, so I don't know. But I kind of want to do an all-over Halloween decorations type of thing, and then of course take it down and redo the entire house for Christmas. If you can see over here, I have my little Halloween lights and these little lanterns right here hanging up. Those light up and they have different little Halloweenish scenes. I think this one here has a jack-o'-lantern, and there's one hanging on the far shelf over there, and it has like a witch's scene. And I also got those from the Dollar Tree. So yay for those. They're super adorable. So the next things I have in here, I was super like astonished, I guess you could say. I didn't expect to find something like this at the Dollar Tree, just because I personally have bought these from Walmart, and at Walmart they're like $3, and of course the Dollar Tree, everything's a dollar. So I got these little ponies. Now, I don't know how many of you guys have little girls in your lives that love My Little Pony, but my friend's daughter is obsessed. So, I also got this little apple strudel. So, all these little ponies were at the Dollar Tree, and I couldn't help but get them because I have been paying $3 for the little ponies at Walmart, and they're at the Dollar Tree. So, for her birthday, I'm just getting as many My Little Pony items as I possibly can, and just, I'm gonna compile them all up and surprise her with them. I cannot wait to see her little face when she sees all of her little ponies. So the next thing that I got is this little, they're just headbands. I don't wear stuff like this, and I don't have a daughter who does either. I just wanted it actually for this one right here. I'm actually gonna attach this to a bow that I made for one of my coworkers. And I probably could have just got a single one there. They have like double ones, but I wanted a pink one in particular because it's for a baby and she's a little girl and you know all that. So I was particular about having a pink one. And the pink ones were only in the little 8-pack there. So c'est la vie. I just bought it. Whatevs. The next thing, I think this is the last My Little Pony thing I have. It's just a little cup. Now at Walmart, they have smaller cups. They're about this big for 88 cents that are My Little Pony. My personal Walmart is sold out of them. So when I saw this regular sized My Little Pony cup at the dollar store, I was like, thank you, thank you, thank you, because Deja is going to love it. So that's the last of the My Little Pony stuff, I think. And the rest is the Halloween stuff. So, on top of the trick-or-treat cups, they had these cups here. I don't know if you can see the design, but it's like, I don't know if that helps. That doesn't help. It's like a skeleton, and they're the same, and it's on both sides. It's like a little skeleton face. And how cute would these be? You, like, fill them up with, like, maybe an orange slushie or something like that, and, like, you just get into the Halloween mood. I am so excited. Halloween is my favorite holiday. I cannot wait. So you can see this is the next thing that is in here. And it just says, Happy Halloween, Nightmare, Haunted, Jack-O-Lantern, Fright, Creepy, and Tricks and Treats. So just, it has a little piece of ribbon here that you can hang it up. I bought a few little hanging up things. I'm not exactly sure what I want to put on which door. Normally I put a Halloween wreath on my front door, but I think that it got damaged, and so I'm not gonna be able to use it this year. So these are some alternatives to that. So the next couple things I got, they're like little paper lanterns. So this one says trick or treat, and it matches the design of the cups that I got. And I plan on getting those little electric LED tea lights to put in it and then popping them up somewhere. And I got another one. The next things that I got are these adorable little sparkly skeletons. They light up. Is it this one? That one doesn't. This one does. So they light up. Oh no. That one's not lighting up. Go figure. But they light up and they change colors. And let me turn his light off. His mandible, it can move. So I think those are adorable. Now, a lot of the things that I got are spooky, but they're sparkly, so that makes it okay, right? Like, definitely. So they have this fright tape, and they have different sayings. Now, this one, you can't really tell, but it says haunted, and it's got little ghosts on it. And then they had caution, they had beware, and they had other stuff like that. I think haunted is super cute, just because it's like a running joke between me and my husband and my friends and everybody. When something weird happens, you're like, oh, you're haunted. So I think that's adorable. So another one of the hanging ideas that I have, it says, today I'm a good witch. And I kind of wish that you could take this off and like it'd say bad underneath. Like, I think that would be adorable. But, you know, that's all right. I think this is adorable. I'm not sure which door I'm gonna put that on yet, but when I do, I'll definitely post pictures. I also got a little bow, and it's got little spiders and spider webs and a ton of glitter. For those of you who don't know me personally, I make bows, and so I thought, how cute would it be to, like, on my front door or something, have like something and a bow and just go with it. I am kind of scatterbrained. I'm not exactly sure what I want to do with everything yet. So I just bought like practically everything that I thought would look adorable. I also got some hair ties because you can never go wrong with hair ties. And 18 for a dollar, I mean, hey, you can get 10 of them for 88 cents at Walmart. So 18 for a dollar, it's working out pretty nice. I got two of these. I wonder if they're in the same bag. They're not. Okay, so they're little candlelight. They're little candles, and they're lights, and you're supposed to be able to just turn it on, and it, like, flickers like a candle would. So, like, my idea is I bought two of these. I'm going to put one on each end of my front window, and then I'm going to strew these little pumpkin lights. It looks like it's upside down. These little pumpkin lights from one candle to the next, and have like flickering lights and little pumpkin lights in between. I think it's a good idea. I bought two of the pumpkin lights just in case one isn't enough, or in case I want to put some pumpkin lights somewhere else. I think that pumpkin lights are adorable, and I can see them like just hanging in my room. So the next thing I got, it also has a little bow on it, and it has hanging glittery bells. So I thought that would be cute, probably to, okay, so like I could put it on my door, or I could put this adorable little hanger on my kid's door, so when they try and sneak out, I'm gonna hear it. Hey, better than an alarm system, right? Plus it's a lot cuter. So the next thing I got are some zipper seal bags, like some Ziploc type bags that have Happy Halloween on them and like a little haunted house. A friend of mine is actually having a Halloween party and she asked me to help her out this year. So party favors are definitely going in these little bags. There's 40 of them in this single pack. So that's exciting. I don't, we'll probably put like popcorn or something in them. I don't really know yet, but it's gonna be going down. All right, I actually think we're on the last bag. So at the top of the bag is the other candle. And okay, so I got these little boxes and I'm not sure what I want to do with them yet. As you can tell, I don't know what I want to do with anything yet, but I got these little boxes and they look kind of cute, you know, like whatever. It says do not disturb, but when you open it up, look, it's a little sleeping Dracula, and on his little blanket it has like blood types. How cute is that? So they had a few different ones. I think I got one of each kind that my particular Dollar Tree offered, but I have seen some other videos where different Dollar Trees had different ones of these. So this one just says Happy Halloween, and when you open it up, it's got a little skeleton and a pumpkin. I think these are so cute, and what I think I'm actually gonna do is I'm probably gonna gift a few of these. This one's fine. If you look on the back, it looks like it's filthy. I was about to be really upset. When you look on the front, it has the same design. So it's got just like chains and a little padlock on it. And when you open it up, it's got a little mummy, and he has a little mummy kitty in there with him. Like, how cute is that? The last thing I got in here is actually not Halloween related. It's just for my kids. It's just a Minion bubble bath because my kids just enjoy bubble baths and Minions. So that is all of the stuff that I got from the Dollar Tree today. I am so excited. I will probably go back for some more stuff. Don't tell my husband. And as soon as I decide where I'm going to put this stuff, I will definitely take pictures and post them somewhere. Facebook, Snapchat, one of those places. Maybe I'll post some pictures on here. I don't really know yet. Anyways, thank you so much for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.